Hello, John Talley here with Boats.net, and today we're going to be taking a look at our 2004 Yamaha F225. And as you can see from the outside, it's looking pretty rough, so I can only imagine what it's going to look like on the inside. What's the best way to look inside one of these machines? Well, we want to start off by doing a compression test only, and you're only going to need one tool to pull that off, so let's step over and look at that. All right, the only special tool you're going to need, like I said, is a compression tester. And if you need to pick one up, why don't you reference that link in the description, and it'll take you straight to a shopping cart where you can go ahead and get one. So once you've got your compression tester, I can go over there and show you how to take those readings. So let's go. So let's start off by popping the cowling off. Just three latches. We can go ahead and lift it off. Next, we have 4 5-millimeter Allens. Actually, two of these are missing, but they're going to be here, 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 and here. There we go. Let's go ahead and pull all of our spark plug leads. When you're pulling these, try to grab them up on this part. Otherwise, you run the risk of actually pulling it out of the boot. And we don't want to make it any worse than it is. With the boots off, let's go and get those plugs out. We'll break them all loose. One of the first things you would look for is the condition of your spark plug. And this one is hiding whatever it has to tell me because these are new. All right, this next part, if you're still connected to your boat, you won't have to do, but I have to go ahead and bring up a power and the ignition connection so I can get it to turn over while it's on the stand. So before we actually hook up the tester, I want to go ahead and hold the throttle body's open. So, of course, if you still have this on your boat, all you need to do is put it in neutral and open your throttle. In my case, we're going to hold it open with a zip tie. So let's go ahead and get our fuel injection disabled. I'm just going to unplug the entire harness. We've already got our throttle bodies held open, and now we can go ahead and start making some measurements. So let's go ahead and start on our right bank and see what this engine's got. More importantly, what it probably doesn't have. Because I've been told that one or more cylinders is down on compression. All right, 50, 60, 70, 170. Not too bad to start with. To get a uniform measurement, you want to get each cylinder turned over the same amount of time. So we're going to be aiming for 7 for each one. It's throwing things at me. 170. So that isn't looking very healthy. We're down to 140. So we got 190 here. Ooh, 160. Last one. I go ahead and tell you that with this much variation, this engine's got a problem. Plus, you'll notice we were higher up here and then we dropped down on the lower cylinders. So whatever's going on, it's indigenous to the bottom side of the power head. And judging by all the oil that's pumping out, there's something catastrophically wrong going on with those two bottom cylinders. All right, guys, that wraps this one up, but obviously we have a lot more work to do to figure out what's going on this motor. Listen, if you want to keep up with that, why don't you go ahead and hit that subscribe button? That way you can keep up with whatever I'm working on next. Listen, if you need parts for your machine, why don't you come see us at boats.net and we can get you taken care of. Have any questions or comments? Why don't you leave them in the section below and I'll do my best to answer them. We just want to say thanks again for shopping here with us at boats.net, and we will see you in the next video. Have a great day.